on state separating proofs of reduction methodology for real world protocols.
Oh, wow, thanks for reading out the title. So that's a more serious talk. So sometimes I suffer. And so this talk is about easing my suffering. So more in detail, key exchange researchers more generally sometimes suffer. And so this is a self-help talk for key exchange researchers. So I want to share my experience as a key exchange researcher and tell you a little bit of how I hope to overcome some of the obstacles of key exchange researchers. So once upon a time, I was a PhD student and I worked on key exchange. And at night, when I wrote proofs, I suffered because there were tons of work. Because key exchange protocols make super, super complicated, especially real world protocols like TLS. And they had many, so the proof, there were many seemingly simple steps. But once I had done the proof, I was not even sure it's right. Yeah, so it was not possible for me to verify where it's right. It was not human verifiable. So one of the worst proofs that I proved was that the Lavrov-Rogoway key exchange protocols are composable with symmetric key protocols. So this is actually very simple. So you have a key exchange protocol that outputs symmetric keys that look random, and then you use them in an application protocol that is secure with random keys. So this should be straightforward, even without using universal composability. So what I was really concerned about is the theorem seems really simple, so why is the proof so hard? So I tried in the CCS paper, I tried in my thesis, my colleague tried in his thesis, and each time the proof looked really, really ugly. So what was the difficulty? So one of the difficulties is that there's state between the key exchange and the application protocol, namely the keys, and this is a multi-session and multi-instance game. So in more detail, how do we prove things? So we would prove things by saying, okay, replace those key, real keys with random keys, and then reduce the security of the application protocol when you use random keys here. And so in each of these steps, you have to maintain lists in the reduction, pass on keys to the right sessions, etc. It's boring. Yeah, it's boring, but it's very complicated, and you have to do it. And in this reduction step, you also have to do it, so it's very annoying. So the first idea is to say, okay, if we share state between those packages, maybe we can move the state to a key package and have the shared state in a modular fashion. And then you have rules to specify those packages. So then you get the reduction automatically. So the idea is that when you reduce to the application protocol, this is your reduction automatically. And so the idea is to define operators that allow you to compose packages. So one is a bracket operator that allows you to parallel composition. And if they use a package, we have a circle operator. And this allows you to do proofs in a very simple way. So then we define some algebraic rules, which, so for example, for the hybrid argument, you can plug in an ID, and this is still the same package. And now you can do a hybrid proof in a very simple way. So this becomes your reduction to the simple assumption. So let's start from the beginning. You want to swap out this package 0 to 1. We do this by moving this package here. This is the reduction. Then we can reduce to this single session assumption. And then we can move it back. And this is automatic. And one doesn't need to do anything for it. So this is just some example. And so those simple steps, they're a little work, they're precise, they're human verifiable. And so a little bit of the notation. So Mike Rosenblatt uses some of those ideas, and especially a very similar notation in the draft of his book, The Joy of Cryptography, which is very, very nice. And he has been using this in his undergraduate classes for many years. So I think this makes this type of notation very usable for making complicated proofs as simple as possible. And I think it's a very useful thing. So our hope that we can use this method to prove TLS 1.3, to use this method for meta reductions, to make key exchange papers readable again, and most of all, to suffer less, and to hopefully understand more. So my request and my suggestion is that if you suffer from writing seemingly simple proof steps or from making them accessible to readers, check whether our annotation can help. And if you have the same struggle in teaching, check whether my book can help you. So many of those conceptual ideas are, of course, not new. Some of them are from the Universal Composability Framework, some are from Random System, Abstract Crypto, Constructive Crypto, some are from the MeTLS work by Microsoft Research and Andrea Paris, some are from the Pi Corpus, and we put those ideas together with a focus on proofs. So we're not trying to find the right model, we're just trying to simplify proofs as much as we can. So it's now an apron, states of writing proofs, the reduction methodology for real protocols, and maybe it can help you too.